driving down to the Bracken Cave Bat Preserve, which is an incredible place in Texas where some 10 million bats make their roosts during the summer months.
I got to spend the afternoon with Merlin, who's like the Jane Goodall of bats.
Hello there.
Hi, Millie.
Hi, Merlin.
Welcome to Bracken Cave.
It's so nice to meet you. This is the hugest colony of bats in the world. And isn't it also the hugest colony of mammals in the world?
That's right. The population here varies greatly depending on whether we're having a drought or whether the weather's good. But when it's at its peak at about 20 million, that's 270 tons of bats all in one place. Mm. That's the biggest aggregation of warm-blooded animals on the planet.
Merlin, tell me about the threats facing this colony of bats and other bats in this area.
Well, bats all across America are threatened by careless development of wind energy. Mm. Those big turbine blades are moving about 180 or more miles per hour at the tips.
Mm.
And a bat's echolocation only reaches a few meters in front. Another threat to these bats is imminent development of the surrounding habitat.
The bats at Bracken Cave are facing a worrisome man-made threat as real estate developers from nearby San Antonio hope to turn this pristine terrain into suburban sprawl.
I'm kind of new to the world of bats, but it seems like a no-brainer. You've got this enormous colony, the biggest colony of mammals in the world. They're doing so many great things for the environment. Why in the world would the community support this development?
It's not the community that's
right.
supporting it. It's developers, and there's a lot of money at stake, and that's what's driving it. This is a World Heritage Site, and we should treat it as such.
I had no idea what Bracken Cave had in store for me. Growing up in bat country, I often saw the winged mammals gracing evening skies, but nothing prepared me for the splendor that lay ahead.
I have to tell you, this is probably the most beautiful thing I have ever seen in my entire life. The sound is incredible. The motion, the movement, and just to see something like this, it's just overwhelming. We've been standing here for 10 minutes, and these bats have not stopped.
By reducing crop damage and pesticide use across the country, bats are worth some $3.5 billion a year.
These bats eat, on a good night, 200 tons of insects, and not just any insects. They're eating crop pests over the winter garden area of Texas. Mm-hmm. If they weren't eating those insects, you'd have more pesticides poisoning your food and polluting your drinking water.
There's millions of bats here. Do they live here year round, or are there just certain times of the year when they're here?
These bats are migratory. They come in the spring, rear their pup. Their longest distance migrations cross the Mexican border.
Are there any lessons you've learned from bats? Any one thing that these bats have taught you or working with bats has taught you over the years?
I certainly learned that animal value is not determined by a popularity contest of what we already know. Bats are very poorly known, but in fact, they're absolutely essential ecologically to everything from deserts to rainforests. There's nothing to fear if you just leave them alone, and there's much to gain from having them around. And one of the things that I've done that's had the most impact is to put bats in a proper light through good photography.
Mm.
You take a picture of a little bat with a head the size of my thumb, blow it up to page size snarling, and it looks like a vicious saber-toothed tiger about to get you.
Right.
I have shown conclusively through my photography that bats can be just as cute and winsome as panda bears, kittens, puppies, anything else.
Wow.
Bats are among the least studied mammals on the planet, and so we're still discovering new species routinely.
I left Bracken Cave knowing that Mexican free-tailed bats aren't just creating beautiful waves in the sky. They're also keeping our ecosystem balanced and insect-free.